Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to Granada, Spain, for the second final of the day, Trap Men. I'm Hillary Russell, and have the pleasure of having Great Britain's one-time World Cup gold medalist, Aaron Heading, with me today. Welcome, Aaron, and thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, Hillary. How are you doing?
I'm doing just fine. It's nice to have you by my side. I'm sorry that you did not make it into the final today. But you do have a gold medal under your belt from the season, which is great.
Yeah, can't believe it. Still hasn't sunk in yet, to be honest.
Really?
It was unbelievable shoot. I don't know how it happened, really.
Well, you never know. Now, we were talking before about the World Cup final, and you're not sure if that's going to be enough to get into the World Cup final, or is it...
We just don't know. The caliber of shooting this year has been just phenomenal. Just take this shoot, for example. The cutoff for the final was a 1-2-3.
Yeah.
What can I say? The caliber of shooting has just got unbelievable this year.
And we're going to have a chance to introduce our six finalists in just a second. There was a seven-way shoot-off for third, fourth, fifth, and sixth place today. And so it was pretty big. And in fact, one of the men that made it into the final semifinal after the shoot-off is Alexei Alipov from the Russian Federation.
Yeah, well done to him. Again, another final and potentially another medal. What can you say? You can never write this guy off, can you?
No, you can't. He's got so many medals under his belt. It's amazing, really. He's got a laundry list on these athletes' presentations that we have. It just goes on and on and on. Really great guy, and we wish him good luck.
Yeah, definitely.
Then in position five, representing France, we have Stéphane Clément.
Yeah, here we go. He's a grand age of 42 and still really holding it in there for the guys. And yeah, good luck to him as well.
And in position four, representing the United States of America, we have Casey Wallace.
Casey Wallace, look at this. This is his third, maybe fourth shoot international, and he's already in a final. So all the best to him, and see what happens.
Let's see if he can hold up with the pressure. You know, being never entering into a final round of a World Cup before, it's a pretty big thing. But in position three, representing Ireland, we have Derek Burnett.
Derek Burnett, let's see if the luck of the Irish is with him today.
And in position two, representing Spain, we have Jesus Serrano.
Fantastic. What a great position to be in at one of his home shoots. And just see what comes up out of the bag today.
And in position one, also representing Spain, we have Alberto Fernandez.
Yeah, this is brilliant. Another great shooting. Another 124 from the chap. And let's just see how he holds himself together.
You know, both of these guys in first and second after qualifications, of course, now the qualification scores are going to be eliminated, and everyone starts off with zero as we go into the semifinal. Can you just talk about the semifinals a little bit and tell us what we can expect?
Yeah, the semifinals, because it's now another competition. Like in Formula One, you have your qualifying events, and now this is the nitty-gritty bit, the final stage, and it's its own competition in itself. And potentially there's another competition for four of the gentlemen after, and see how they bear up.
Let's talk about how many clays and all of that during the semi-final.
Okay, in the first semi-final, we have 15 targets each, and in that, the top four potentially going to a badge match, which is cut in two as well. There's a bronze medal match and a gold and silver medal match, and the fifth and sixth place are eliminated, and then after we have the bronze medal match. Again, they shoot another 15 targets, and if there's a clear-cut winner after the 15, then that's that. If not, there's a shoot-off which follows, and then once that's cleared, we have the gold medal match, and literally exactly the same, 15 targets, and see how they go.
And also before the bronze medal match and before the silver and gold medal matches, once again the scores are cancelled out and they all start at zero again.
Yeah.
So it's really anybody's game. First of all, you just want to get into one of the medal matches without a doubt.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, anything can happen there. And here we go.
Tell me what you think about this range, Aaron. Do you like it?
Yeah,
I love it.
It's with the contrast of the heat and with the light on the targets, it just goes to show, if you look at the scores here this weekend, it's it really, really brings the target out, and it actually makes it really hard to not see the target.
Mm-hmm.
And it's quite embarrassing when you miss it, to be honest.
All right, this is the first one for Wallace. the first time entering into a final round of a World Cup. Now you can see that the powder from the clay went off of our monitor really, really fast because of the wind that's blowing. Tell us about that today during qualifications. Was that bothering you at all?
No, I think it's welcomed by a lot of the shooters because it just cools the air down a little bit and just so we don't get too overheated, really.
Right.
It's quite draining.
But it's not playing with the targets.
Doesn't seem to be too much today. Yesterday the wind was a little bit more and was pushing some of the low targets down. But today it doesn't seem to be affecting them today.
Okay, on to Serrano.
Oh.
And Serrano with a hit.
Yeah, the ball got off to a great start.
A really great start. Yeah.
Yep. There goes Fernandez and two. Really good start from everybody.
It would be, we were talking about Fernandez earlier about how fast he shoots. In my opinion, in the old style at least, he was probably the fastest trap shooter. He would call and shoot at the same time. It was really hard for our cameraman actually to get images of him because it was so fast. But you're saying now that it seems like he's slowing down a bit.
Yeah. I don't know if it's just because it's his first shoot this year and he's just getting back into it, which is it's hard to believe because he's just shot a 124 in qualification.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Really.
And it looked like he slowed down a little bit, but I hope he speeds up again.
All right, on to Clemens. This is great, starting off, everyone hitting the first target. That's definitely the way to go. And it's very impressive, in my opinion, for Wallace, who, we were watching yesterday, there were three women in the trap event who had never entered into a final round of a World Cup, and all three of them missed their first target.
Yeah,
Once
you get that first shot underway, I think the nerves start to go and you start shooting your competition and here you go. Wallace unfortunately just missed the target there by the looks of it, but he'll get himself underway again.
Yeah, he will definitely. He was shooting very, very well today. He was one of the gentlemen that was in the shoot off to get in today's final. Again on to Burnett. Let's just take a look at Burnett for a second.
Yeah. Here he goes. He's still shooting with his Barazzi.
The last time that Burnett has won a medal, a World Cup medal, was back in 2007. And so I bet he's pretty hungry for one right now.
Yeah, yeah. To be honest, he's been really close the last few shoots now. I think he's just had one average round, really, just knocked him out. And but today he's back on form and he's got five good qualification rounds and he's in the final.
And Fernandez finishing off with two hits. This is great. Now we just have Wallace and Serrano now with a miss. Everybody else is par.
Yep, here comes Alipov.
Alipov's very, very great to watch because he gets into the zone and you can see it. Something snaps with him. And it's very, very consistent that he is doing his routine all the way through to the follow-through. And you can almost feel it as a spectator.
Yeah,
when this happens.
Yeah, I think it's actually bred into him, to be honest. I think because remembering that in the Olympics that gone by, his father was an Olympic gold medalist, and so really, I think it's a bit of it has to do with it. It's into the breed.
Yeah. Okay, we got Wallace coming off of a miss.
Here he goes.
And with another.
Yeah. It's okay. It's a great experience for him. No doubt. He's only 21, I think he is. And
I think that he is. 21 or 20.
Yep. And it's just his fourth World Cup. And what can I say? He's in a final. So
that's right.
That's great.
And, we're so early into the semifinal
exactly,
right now.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Anything could happen. Just hopefully mentally it won't get to him. He is young. And I'm sure they've had a lot of mental training as well. But you don't want to get that under your or in your brain too much.
No. Oops. Oh, this looks like a Derek Burnett is protesting the target. Let's just see what the referees say.
Now, when there's a pause like this, Aaron, when there's a protest or something like that, or something happens to the machines, what does that do to you?
For me personally, you just have to carry on with the shoot because you just don't know what happens. And now just looking at Derek, we're just seeing that he's just seeing what's the
he's
outcome.
Not looking very happy. I'm
no.
kind of thinking they did not give that to him.
No, by the looks of it, he's not got up target there. And then Serrano's just come back with a hit.
Oh.
Fernandez straight back in.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
You know, just incredible, incredible competition. And now he's showing what he's made of. And he actually is tied up. We've got a three-way tie between Alipov, Clemens, and Fernandez. Two-way tie for fourth between Burnett and Serrano. And Wallace has moved down to sixth place. And unfortunately, that's the way that it happens now with this new finals format.
Exactly.
You know, you just miss a couple and you go down to six.
Well, exactly. And because there's only 15 targets, again, it can all change in the last three or even the last target.
All right, so it looks like we're going to get things going once again. Back on to Alipov.
Here he goes.
Nice.
Nice another hit there.
Also, Clemens, who is shooting a perfect semi-final at the moment.
Yeah, he's really took to that gamble that he's shooting now. I think he shot it the first time in Lonato last year, in fact, and which I think he was in the final again. And it looks like he's taking like that to a duck to a water.
Okay, we've got Wallace coming off of two misses with a hit. He definitely just smashed that one squarely, and we're going to be moving forward now and focus in on Burnett.
Here he goes. Let's see if he can get over that last miss there.
It's nice to see a member from the Irish team in.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. In fact, I think there's been an Irish lady shooter as well.
Mm-hmm.
And Derek wasn't alone. He had a partner in the men's event.
Nice, and he's gotten back into the groove here with the hit. And back on now to Serrano.
Ball.
Ooh, what happened there?
Oh!
It was a miss.
That was a miss. That's too bad. And Fernandez is already hit. This is how fast he goes. We don't even have a chance to see him.
He's already halfway to peg one. Okay, maybe he hasn't slowed down. Maybe he hasn't.
It doesn't seem like he really has. If he speeds up too much, he doesn't even have to be here.
Let's exactly, yeah. Yeah.
Okay, back on to Alipov.
Look at that beautiful scenery at the back there.
It's really beautiful.
Yeah, yeah. Over to the right-hand side, we've got the Sierra Nevada mountains, and it's really one of the picturesque places to shoot, definitely.
And they still have snow on those mountains.
Yeah.
Which is lovely.
I just couldn't believe it.
I know, we're sweating down here when it's like 40 degrees Celsius.
Yep.
And that's a first miss there for Clemens. And on now to Wallace.
Yeah, he's getting underway.
He's got that signature squatting USA team.
Quite unique, isn't
it? Yes, it really is.
It's great because, I remember in the days of Lance Bade and people like that, it obviously works in respects, you know, because he's in the final. He shot 123 and he's in the final, so you can't say it doesn't work.
Corey Cogdale yesterday, she has more or less the same.
Exactly, yep.
And she made it onto the podium yesterday with the bronze.
Yep. Here's Derek with his quite straight.
So it looks like they have fixed that score. Maybe that's what the discussion was all about. Because
exactly.
He does not have a miss anymore.
Oh. Yeah, very strange.
Oh.
2 seconds for Fernandez.
Ready? Now back to Alipov. I think he had a really good winter because I think he had took a long break after London, and he was in the last two World Cups, and straight into a final in the last World Cup as well. I think
that's right. He actually won the bronze in Nicosia.
Yep. So just obviously the break did him well.
Generally in the winter, what do you do? Do you just take some time off as well, or?
No, I still shoot. I still shoot through the winter. It's just because it's just not a great deal to do.
Yeah.
Because it all depends on where the World Cups are for the following year, because we had them quite early this year.
Mm-hmm.
The first one in Mexico. So literally had to for the past 3 years now just training all year round. I better book those tickets for a holiday soon.
Better. It's time for a holiday, Aaron.
Yeah.
Okay, back on now to Burnett. Well, it's a good thing that he did protest that
That target, yeah. Because it looks like he's been given.
Oh!
Here he goes. Yep.
He's really shooting strong. We're going to have a talk with him after this.
Yeah.
And what in the world he's been doing lately.
Oh, he's got the look for him today, hasn't he?
That's right, the old Irish look.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh.
Right. Oh, we actually see Fernandez shoot one there. That was
unbelievable, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so let's just take a look at the standings after six targets. We have Alipov, Burnett, and Fernandez all tied up with perfect 6 out of 6. Clemens is in fourth place, and tied up for fifth, we've got Wallace and Serrano. We still have quite a bit to go before this final or semifinal is over. But if you were to put your money on anybody, who would you put it on to make it into the gold medal match? It's difficult. We've got a three-way tie right now.
You know, I'm going to go for Fernandez and Alipov for a gold medal match.
All right.
Yeah. And what's your prediction, Hillary?
I can't. All right. 9 more targets to go in this semifinal before we find out who's going to end up in the bronze medal match and who's going to end up in the gold medal match. Yeah. Alipov shooting absolutely as strong as can be. He's really, you're right. You know, after that break, he just is shooting incredibly, incredibly well.
I'm feeling that confident. I'm going to go with Stefan Clements and Wallace in the bronze medal match.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm feeling confident today.
All right. I'm going to have to write this down.
Yeah.
And there he is. Casey Wallace.
Hey.
Nice.
Yeah. Oh, but I didn't put Derek in, did I?
You didn't?
No, I didn't think of that one.
Yeah, and he's got a perfect semi-final so far.
Exactly, yeah, yeah.
Well, I didn't bet you any money, so. Okay, back on to Derek Burnett.
Ooh.
Nice.
Yeah, he's looking really, really cool out there. Nearly at the halfway stage.
Serrano just had a couple little bleeps at the beginning, and he's right back into it again.
Yep.
Fernandez is showing us what he's made of. He's definitely on the mission to make his country proud, being right here in his home.
Yeah. At the moment, his current world ranking is 95. I think that's going to go up a little bit this time.
I have a feeling. Okay, back on now to Alipov.
Here he goes.
Yep, it's a hit.
Now onto Clemens. The breeze is picking up a little bit more. But it doesn't seem to be affecting them.
No, it really doesn't.
And as I say, the light is just phenomenal out there.
Nice.
Oh, that's a great shot from the cameraman there to get that one in.
Well, they definitely do work hard. I can tell you that much. Maybe this blazing sun.
Oh, yeah, exactly. No, definitely.
You know, yesterday, it looked like the wind was really hitting the women right square on. I mean, it was hard to say not being right there on site.
Yeah.
But it really looked like that was the situation. Now it just more or less looks like it's coming from the left and a little bit behind.
Yeah, literally the opposite direction, which isn't bad. The you know, it can push the targets upwards if it was coming into your face.
Oh,
nice.
Serrano back on it again.
He really is. Just 2 misses and.
Oh.
That was a first miss there for Fernandez.
Yeah, that wasn't in the script.
No, it certainly wasn't, was it? We've got some of the USA shooters here. And coach, that's Jeffrey Holguin. He's getting ready for the double trap event that's going to be taking place in a couple days. And on now to Alipov, who is shooting a perfect final up to now.
Here he goes. Oh, no. Whoa, another one. Now, what happened there?
I have a feeling probably he saw a piece of the target come off because he made a little... But he not quite sure. We got to see what the. It must be a tough job being a referee, you know? It really must be to see. Make sure you're just watching all the time. You've got to be on all the time.
Yeah, yeah. And let's just see what the referee's decision here. This is a tough call. Here we go.
Yeah, Alapa was very adamant about the fact that he had done... What, let's take a look.
We've gone to Clements. Let's just see what the...
Yeah, we'll take a look at the standings in just a couple of minutes.
Yep.
Oh.
Nice.
Yeah, we never get this sort of excitement in the final normally, do we? It normally goes smooth and everything like this, but no.
Exactly.
Two protests this time. Here we go for Wallace.
Hey.
No.
Oh. Now what happened there? Looks like a no target on that one.
He's going to have to reshoot and see what's going to happen with it.
Yeah, the just as the target came out there, underneath the clay targets for the final, there's a cardboard pad that holds the powder in. When the target was released there, it looked like he dropped out very early. So he's the referee called it a no target, and now he gets to shoot it again. There we go.
There we go, nice.
And straight away. No trouble.
Not at all. He didn't seem to have had that phase him at all, which is great. Being the first time in a final round of a World Cup, and he's really holding himself together, I think, coming off those two misses.
Yep.
And you can see that he's got quite a lot of confidence in his face. I mean, it doesn't look like he was really put out by those two misses.
No, it looks like he's just applied the lip seal on his lips again. whatever works, whatever works.
Burnett, who's got a perfect final going on right now,
I think you've just given the kiss of death there.
I did. Yeah. I really did. And I'm sure that Fernandez must be just breathing a nice, fresh breath of relief, knowing that he's going to be square and square.
Here we go.
There we go. Now we'll have a chance to take a look and see what's going on with Alapov, if they counted it or they didn't.
Here's the stand-ins.
And they did not let him get away with it. So Alapov, Burnett, and Clemens are still tied up for first place. Oh, and also Fernandez, all tied up for first place. And for fifth place, we've got Wallace and Serrano tied up.
Yeah, it's still very, very close.
Yeah, it is very, very close.
All missed a target now. A couple of us missed one more. Coming to the latter stages now of the semi-final. And...
Now I think that's someone like Alapov. I mean, he's used to it. He's shot so many finals in his life. But, you know, there's a general consensus that I've heard is that the first few targets and the last few targets are the hardest. Would you agree with that or not?
I think they're all hard.
Good point, Aaron. Good point.
I think there's no easy targets there. Here he goes again. He's just going through his routine again. With six targets to go.
And all of these guys know where they're standing right now. We've got Jack Jay, who was with us this year, and he's announcing live right down there on the field of game and field of play. And so they know where they're standing, and it's something new for everybody.
Exactly, yeah. Yep. Here we go, Stefan Clemens.
Oh.
Nice.
Yeah.
Only one miss for Clemens. This is really great shooting. So I'm really impressed, actually, by what's happening today in today's semifinal. Again, now on to Wallace.
To be honest, it's been really impressive the whole weekend. You know, for. Here he goes.
Nice.
Nice, straight into it. Yeah, I don't know if it's just because the sun's out and. You know, there's a good real feel-good factor with the shooters at the moment. And I think it's just shown in people's scores this weekend.
Just saw Fatima Galvez from the Spanish team here to shoot on to cheer on her two team members. Ooh. I'm back on to her net, coming off a miss with a hit.
Yeah, he's back underway again. Jesus, sorry. Back with a hit.
And Fernandez.
Oh!
Yes. He, you know, because he shoots so fast, it makes it look like it's so easy. And God knows it's not easy.
You're exactly right. No, whatever works.
Now tell me, Aaron, about how many times a week do you train? And what does your training consist of?
Now, it all depends on what time of the season and things like this, because the next championship for me is the European, so we just got to look at when it is and build up towards it. Really, because we have quite a lot of selection shoots in the UK,
mm-hmm.
so we use them mostly for training as well, because you can't beat competition for good competition for training. And just go from there, really. Just it all depends on how I feel at the time, if I need to do more or sometimes less. Just to go with the motions, really.
Right. It's another hit there for Wallace.
Yeah, he's in good standing still. It's all within one target of everybody. And here's Derek.
Now you were saying there's two of the Irish team are here, is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. Which is good because I think Derek. Oh no, he just lost a target there.
Oh, look at him. You can tell that he is not at all pleased with that result.
No. Oh, and Serrano with a miss. And now Fernandez.
Oh.
With a hit.
With a hit.
Yep, there we go.
So things are going to change around a little bit. I have a feeling that Serrano and, or at least Wallace, is pretty pleased with what the outcome right now. This could be moving him up the scoreboard.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. It's. I think it will put him in at the moment in a bit of a tie situation. Now with Alipop, with just four targets to go, it still is anybody's game.
And it does look like the wind's picking up just a little bit.
Yeah. I don't know if it's that. Maybe that could be the reason that there's a couple of targets got lost there. And they wasn't expecting the wind to pick up. And they puffed on it with a hit.
Right, also Clemens. He's doing a great job.
Yeah.
Really, really good shooting. And that will maintain his position in the lead. That stance is amazing. It's with this squatting type of shot, the elbows are right out as well.
Yeah, I think that was a no target there again, so it'll get that to shoot that target again. Yeah, it's a very mechanical way of standing, isn't it?
It really is, yeah.
Here he goes again.
No.
Oh, and another no target.
He's kind of being riddled with them. The only guy he... Well, has it been more just or only on Wallace, I think?
Oh, yeah, I think it was just Wallace that's just had a target. The referee just getting ordered to the squad again.
That is one big deep breath he just took. Come on, let's just make it happen, please.
Here we go. Let's hope it's a whole one. There we go, underway.
Nice work.
Yep, definitely, here we go. Now to the last three targets each of everybody.
Back on now to Burnett, coming off of a miss.
Oh, I'm a little premature. There's four more targets for Derek.
That's okay. Sometimes it's difficult to understand what's happening with this new, you know, step back and
step
forward. So
yeah,
I won't hold you accountable. How about that?
Oh, thank you.
Okay, we've got Serrano coming off of a miss.
And a hit.
Nice.
There we go. And now Fernandez.
Oh.
Yes, he's made it look just about as easy as can be. Of course it isn't, but I think we're going to have now a two-way tie for first place. Let's take a look between, three-way, sorry, Alipov, Clemens, and Fernandez. Wallace and Burnett are still tied up now, and Serrano is holding on to six by himself.
Yep. And we'll see now the last three targets for everybody, and let's see how those holdings, how those scores hold up.
And if we see the shooting as it has been happening, we're going to probably go into at least one shoot-off to find out who's going to be going into the medal matches.
Yeah, that's the way it looks at the moment. But now these are the money-making targets now, coming into the last few. Here's Alipov. It's almost like he knew where that target was going.
We've got Clemens, who is in contention for a shoot-off for first place.
Yep. He's just made that a little bit stronger with the hit there. And now back to Wallace.
Hey.
Oh.
That is too bad for Wallace.
Here we go. It still could all change.
That's true. Three more to go for Burnett.
With watching the misses there, the nerves have got to get to them now. Ooh. with the last few targets to go.
Is that how you feel when the last, if there's a couple misses, does that feel like it's contagious to you, or?
It can be, yeah. It can be to the squad, or even, you know, to the shooter there.
Oh.
You can go. It can really go either way. Yeah, Serrano and Fernandez there with both good hits, keeping them in good stead. Serrano looks like he's got over his little his little blips there.
Oh yeah, I'm sure that he has. He's probably kicking himself in the shins though for having them in the first place, but.
Look, we're all human. It can happen
to anybody.
Yeah.
Again, back on to Alipov.
Oh.
And things are going to change around. Look at.
Looking from that reaction, I think he missed it.
Yes, I believe he did. You can tell he's not at all happy with that outcome. Oh. And now it's on to Clemens.
Oh,
and
also with a hit miss. Oh. We saw the referee's hand there.
Okay, we've got Wallace coming off of a miss.
Aye.
But that's not affected him because he's a hit it.
All right, so now we're going to be showing, going on to Burnett, but Fernandez, if he can just finish off, he's going to be definitely going for the gold medal
match.
Exactly,
yeah. Yeah, he's looking very strong here now. Here goes Derek. He's looking pretty good. Oh no. It's okay. It's still the way it looks like it's tying up. It can.
You are really right. These last few targets are tough ones, aren't they?
Exactly. Yep.
Oh.
Take a look, Fernandez.
Not
has
that
done
it looks like for Fernandez.
No,
he's straight in there again.
He is.
Coming down now to the last target.
Alipov coming off of a miss. This is going to change the way that he's standing right now, but does not cancel out the chance to make it into the gold medal match.
And he's finished with a hit there. So we have to see now what the other finalists now. So see how they fare up.
Nice. Also, Clemens finishing off with a hit.
I think there's going to be a few shoot-offs while I look at this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, unlucky. Unlucky Wallace.
Yeah, that's...
At the end of the day, for his first final, that was amazing shooting from him.
It really, really was. But it is a shame. You know, to finish off with a miss, everyone says that's just the worst way to finish off.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
That you overanalyze it a bit after the competition or after the semifinal. All right, and we've got Burnett, who is coming off a miss.
Here we go. Oh, and a great finish. Mm-hmm. Great
Perfect.
Finish.
Really had a great start to the semifinal.
Yep.
And again, on to Serrano. Finishing
finish
off clean dice.
No, this says...
And
Fernandez with a hit.
Lovely shooting
go.
From Fernandez. Finishing off with 14 out of 15 and in first place by himself.
Phenomenal shooting.
Really, really great. We're going to take a look at the standings and see what's going to be going on now as far as shoot-offs go and gold medal matches. We are going to have to unfortunately say goodbye to Wallace in the United States of America. He did a fine job to get into the semifinal today, and I'm sure we're going to see him around again.
Definitely. We're shooting like that, definitely.
Okay, so Fernandez, he knows where he stands. Definitely in the gold medal match. Now we just have to figure out who is going to be in the bronze medal match and who's going to be the other person participating in the gold medal match.
That's why we can be here well, Hillary.
You poor thing. I basically manhandled you to come and commentate with me. And with that said, we're going to be sitting here for quite a while.
Yeah.
And you haven't eaten still, have
exactly
you?
Exactly right,
you know?
Yeah.
Poor guy.
I know. I don't know what I'm running on.
Now you could see with Burnett when he missed the clays in the semifinal, you could tell emotionally it was really affecting him. And
yeah,
it's nice that he's had this break right now to kind of get it back together.
Exactly, yeah. I don't know if it's just the heat got to him or something like that, because obviously coming from Ireland, a sun is quite a rarity by the looks of things.
Absolutely.
Here he goes. A great start with a hit there.
And again now, on to Serrano. You know, Serrano obviously wants this. Any chance that Spain could have two of their men on the podium.
Exactly, yeah. Oh. And he's doing good today because he's just hit his target as well. Now back onto Derek again. The targets are random so that no one knows what target they've got. All they know is just going to go straight away.
And in the old style, then you knew.
Yeah, exactly. The referee would call off the target and then the... whichever shooter would shoot the same target, and then and the guy after them as well would always shoot the same target. And they could either be very short results or very long results, just because if you get into a nice rhythm to it, where I think it's better the way it is now that it's a random target.
I think so too. I think it makes it a little bit more exciting. I don't know how it feels for you guys, but for us as spectators, and it seems a little bit more exciting.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, we just don't know what can come out. Here goes Derek now with two good hits behind him. Certainly doesn't look like he's being affected by the sun now. Here he goes.
Ooh.
No. Now. With no target there, that could just get him a little bit...
Distracted a little
bit,
no?
Yeah, exactly. Very high-pressure situation now. He's ready straight off.
Ooh.
Nice.
Nerves are still on that one. Nerves are still.
Again on to Serrano.
Oh.
Nice.
Nice, another great hit there. Well, I think we better order those sandwiches because I think we're going to be here a long time.
I think you've got a good point. This is the thing, you know, these guys get into a rhythm and into a groove about it. There's no stopping them.
Exactly, yeah, yeah. Especially after what they shot in the qualifying rounds, then what they shot in the final.
Oops.
And I've just maybe just said, I spoke about it a bit too quick there. Derek just missing.
But he can't give up. He can't himself all worked up, because if Serrano doesn't make it, the show will go on.
Exactly right. Here we go now.
Oh. And he's done it.
Yeah. It was good, great shooting from Serrano there. Unlucky, Derek.
It was very unlucky, unfortunately. But God, I'm really happy to see that he got into the final.
Exactly.
To see Ireland in a semifinal, and he did his best, and that's all that anyone can ask from him. And
exactly. Yeah. 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 No, that's great shooting there. Great shooting.
So we're gonna have to go into another shoot-off now, and that will be between Alipop and Clemens.
Yep, that's correct.
To find out who will be going into the gold medal match against Fernandez, and obviously the other will be going into the bronze medal match with Serrano.
Yeah. Well, the looks of that flag, that wind's picked up a little bit more as well.
It certainly has. Okay, so if you're going to put your money on anybody here, who are you going to do it?
Whoa, now you've put me in another good position again.
Right. You know, this is a good position to be in for this shoot-off, because you know that either way you're going to end up in a medal match.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So that must take a little bit of the pressure off.
No,
not at all.
I don't think, because you're still in a position that, I think, now that we know that there's one of them's in the gold medal match, one of them's in the bronze medal match, but with one person there, they still can go home with nothing.
Right.
You know, after phenomenal shoot that all weekend,
mm-hmm.
you can still may go home with nothing, which is terrible, really, because, you know, after shooting what you've had to do to get in the qualifying rounds. Yeah. Oh.
Whoa, that was not expected from Alipov.
No.
And once again, he can't let his guard down.
Exactly, here
but
comes
I have a feeling that Clemens is going to definitely take an advantage of this. He's got the door of opportunity wide open right now.
Yep. That's a nice shot there of the Gamba.
Now, you said he's been shooting with this for about a year now?
About a year, yeah.
Yeah,
and it looks like he's got right into it. Right into it.
Whoa.
And he's in.
And there you
and
go.
And he's in.
And
there
he's
you go.
Psyched. He's in and he's psyched.
Yep. Well, there's Clemens guaranteed to go home with a medal today.
That's right. You got the gold or the silver, who knows? But one or the other. And you can be rest assured that Alipov is going to be fighting for that bronze medal.
Yeah, exactly. And here he goes. He's getting himself ready.
So we're going to start off now, Aaron, with the bronze medal match. Once again, all the scores are going to be erased, and the men start with zero. We'll be having 15 targets each, and whoever has the highest score at the end will go home with the bronze. The other one, unfortunately, will go home in fourth place. It's a tough one, this medal match,
exactly,
I think.
Exactly, yeah, yeah. And providing that is, of course, if they're not tied at the end, we could still have another shoot-off situation.
That's true. In fact, if there is a tie, we go into a sudden death shoot-off right immediately after. And, you know, like you were saying, you started at 9:30 this morning.
Exactly. It's a very long day.
You know,
day.
We're already 5 minutes past 6 in the evening.
Yep. Yeah. And of course, in the sun as well. And, you know, it certainly does take it out of you.
Excellent competition so far. All of our athletes having to work extremely hard for their
players. Okay, here we go. We're just waiting for the scoreboard to change, and it looks like it's up and running now.
Two shoot-offs to decide.
Here we go.
I'm going to just focus in on Alipov and Serrano going for that bronze medal. You can rest assured that Serrano is going to want to be on that podium today. I mean, I can just imagine the spectators, the Spanish spectators here today, what would happen if he does win the bronze medal, and Fernandez obviously will win a gold or a silver medal. And they have a good way of celebrating, let's put it that way.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. No, it's definitely a good testament to the team there. They're all very close teammates there, and they all want to see each other do well.
Of course. So what are you thinking?
Well, the referee's just given two thumbs up there, so he's looking like he's pretty excited for it.
Who are you thinking is going to be on the podium? It's a tough one.
I'm going to say Serrano. I want to see the two Spaniards on the podium. That'd be
great.
Well,
you know, you had Wallace and Clement going for the bronze, and we've got a completely different cast and crew now.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. I noticed you wrote that down.
All right, Alapov starting off strong as well as Serrano.
Yep. Both got into it great here. That was a shot of the shotgun referee there.
Okay,
again, Alipov is protesting that he hit the target again.
Let's see what they're going to do, if they're going to allow it or not. He does protest. He absolutely does.
Well,
I think if you believe in it, then absolutely, you got to do it.
If you believe that you hit it, then you've got to protest it if you think that they hit it. The referee just got back into focus.
Ready?
Okay, let's just see what happens now. Because at the end of the day, if Alipov did hit the target, then it would just be reset and then be called off again, so it showed as a hit. But it doesn't look like that's happened.
It certainly doesn't.
Oh no, it did!
Yes, it does!
Oh, there you go, see?
Things just changed around a little bit slower than we thought. And so the two men are up neck to neck, starting off this bronze medal match in style.
So, from a spectator's perspective, how do you think the finals fare up?
I think they're really pretty interesting to watch. I get a lot of feedback from the shooters as well, of what they like and what they don't like. And so I have to be a little bit on the fence about it.
Yeah, I understand that.
Of course, we cover rifle and pistol as well. And so some of the new formats there are much more exciting to watch than they were in the past. With shotgun, I really do have to say I do like the new format for skeet.
Oh, that's brilliant, yeah.
And I think there's some things that are going to be looked at, and we'll see what happens in the future.
Yeah, definitely.
12 targets remain to decide the bronze medal.
Okay, back on now to Alipov.
Looking as focused as ever. Now
that is not going to be playing in his behalf by any means, but we're really early into this, and we'll just have to see if Serrano can just keep the pressure on.
And he couldn't by the looks of it. No, unfortunately not, no.
I'm sure that Alipov must be a little bit relieved there.
Exactly, you know? Yeah. And obviously he felt that he didn't need to protest that target.
Okay.
Back off with a hit there. I think that was safe to say he definitely hit that one.
I can be rest assured. We can see all the powder flying through the sky. Again on to Serrano.
Now.
Okay. So everything right now is in Alipov's favor. He's surprised me today with a couple misses that I was not really expecting. So
yeah. But again, it's just a great testament to see that he is actually human.
Exactly. Okay.
He's back under the way with things. Let's see if Serrano can follow suit with a hit here. With 10 targets to go, it's still all to play for. Oh. And he is. He's back off away there.
Well, anything can happen. We still have 9 more targets to go. Alipov up by 1. And I'm sure that he's going to be putting the pressure on. But as you said earlier, it does look like the wind's picked up a little bit more.
Yeah,
I don't really know if that's going to be affecting them too much.
Looking at that flag, it's just holding for bare life there. And here we go. For the 7th target now.
Nice. He definitely has gotten back into
the swing of things.
That's right.
Nearly at the halfway stage now. So I'm looking like he's got back onto it again. With the great support from the home crowd here, he's certainly got some good support.
He sure does. Plus just his team members too, you know?
Yeah.
Even having some of the trap women or the trap women, some of the trap women shooters here, that you know, they've already finished off their finals and semifinals and everything, and have come back here today to see what's going on, which is great.
Yep. Yeah, Alipov there back with another hit again. So Rana going in for his shot now.
Nice. Now it seems like they're getting into more of a groove.
Exactly, yeah.
Just waiting for the right time. A very talented shooter, you know, winning 2 Olympic Games medals. That says a lot for you.
Yeah, what can you say? He's even from a junior, looking at the junior stats here, that he's won many medals. Looking at 3 silver medals in juniors and 2 gold medals, that's just the European Championships as well. So that's just you know, from an early age, by the looks of it, he's had it in him. So you know, and now at the tender age of 37.
He still has it in him.
Yeah, definitely.
Still up by 1. Alipov over Serrano. 6 more targets to go. Nice. He just hits that squarely, and moving back on to Serrano.
Yep, and Serrano. At his age of 34, he looks like he's been doing it a fair while now. In fact, it looks like it's going to come up to his birthday soon. And with 1 or 2 World Cup gold medals under his belt.
Yeah, his season, where we really started to see him shine was in 2011, says Serrano. Then, you know, last year he also won the bronze medal during the World Cup final in Maribor. So he's somebody to keep our eye on, definitely, without a doubt.
Yeah, exactly right, yeah. And we've just missing out in the Olympics as well with a medal. I think he finished in 5th place there in the Olympic Games last year. So, you know, it's great things for him, sure, still to come.
4 more targets to go, and if Alipov can keep on crushing these clays the way that he's been doing it, the bronze will be his.
Yeah.
But like I said, he's been surprising me a little bit off and on today, so I'm not quite sure. I wouldn't put my money down on anybody right now.
No, that's a safe bet, that Hillary. Obviously wasn't happy with that, so he'll do it again.
Now, when that happens, is it an instant click in your head that says, okay, stop?
Yeah, it depends on if you're feeling lucky or not. If you think that you can just carry on, then carry on. It all depends on how you feel at the time.
But for non-shooters, viewers that are non-shooters, tell us exactly what happens at that point. What causes you to stop?
In case you like mismounted or something, you know, for example, even a bird may have flown across you and just you know, just took your eye away a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But for some people, just carry on like if nothing's happened. Some people just die again. It all depends on how you feel on that particular moment, I think.
Right, right. Alipov's still up by one.
Yeah.
Three more targets to go.
Yeah.
He's got Fernandez there. He'll be the next one to be entering into a medal match. Okay. Like you said, it's the last three targets that things kind of change around sometimes.
Exactly. Hmm. Yeah, these are the game changers now. Hmm. With Alipov with one miss here. All it needs is just one target, and then we're back to square.
And he's not going to let you see that happen.
Now Serrano coming in.
Oh.
Good.
And nice. It was in for the kill on that one. That
nice
was
solid hit, yeah.
Coming down to the last two. Let's see if Alipov can hold his focus here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he looked like he, that gun was moving to that target before he called. That's how confident he's feeling at the moment.
They must just really be sweating bullets out there, though, really.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, unless that's a Oh, I thought that was
no,
a miss.
No,
dear Lord, thank goodness.
Yeah, he did hit it. And here we're down now for the last target, which Alipov needs to hit to secure his secure the bronze medal here.
No pressure there, huh?
None at all. And here he goes.
And there you go. The bronze once again is for Alipov. Very, very nice shooting from Alexei Alipov, winning his second bronze medal of the year. Let's just see how Serrano cleans up.
Yeah, cleans up with
nice.
A hit.
Nice, beautiful. He just
great
had that
to finish.
Little teeny, you know, hiccup in his bronze medal match, but the bronze medal obviously is going now to Alexei Alipov from the Russian Federation. You know, just coming off of winning the bronze just a couple of weeks ago in Nicosia, and going home with another one.
Yeah, looks like he's really getting back to form again. Really getting back to form.
And Jesus Serrano will be going home in fourth place. He did put up a great fight, and
definitely.
You can see that.
Definitely can
Fernandez.
Hold his head up.
Yeah, absolutely.
That was a great performance there from him.
So we'll be going into the gold medal match now between Stefan Clemens and Alberto Fernandez. And that's going to be a hard one to call also, although I have a feeling this gold medal match is going to go a whole lot faster with the way that Fernandez shoots. So
yeah,
he might be giving Clemens a little bit of running time behind him.
Exactly,
you know?
Yeah. Go. There's Fernandez got his back number sorted.
How old were you, Aaron, when you started shooting?
I was 9 years old when I was very first shot a gun, and then started doing a little bit of competitions shortly after, and then it just so happened when I was 12 years old, went to an Olympic trap shoot, knew mm-hmm. nothing about it. Went to it, and me and my father, and we shot, and then at the end of it, didn't realise that I qualified for the team. I just couldn't believe it. Yeah, my very first shoot, and then I was very lucky that it just so happened the way things felt, that the shortcoming months that I was turning 13, and on my 13th birthday, actually, I ended up shooting abroad. I think it was Croatia. I think it was all those years ago. So yeah, it's been I've been in the team for a while now.
That's wonderful. That is great. So just introducing the gold medal match contenders here, and they look like they've got some good sportsmanship, giving each other a handshake before they start off.
Yeah, and here we go, Fernandez. Just making sure the gun still fits.
nice deep breath there from Fernandez. You know, the pressure definitely is on him to make it to the highest of the podium, but you know, God love him. He's gotten where he is already.
Exactly.
This is the first World Cup that he's shot in this year.
Yep.
And
straight in at the top.
Yep.
Here we go. Oh, he's just Stefan Clemens there, just making sure as well that everything's still okay. And we go straight in now with no need to clear the guns because we all know that they work. And here we go.
All right, let's get this going now with Clemens.
Let's see how this one starts. The wind's still being with us. Cool things down a little bit.
Whoa.
There we
go. Definitely. Fernandez definitely has the upper hand here. He's used to this weather.
Exactly, yeah. Whoa. Yeah.
Nice.
And both start with a perfect hit each.
You can tell the pressure is really on him, though, you know? Clemens seems like he's a little bit agitated here.
Exactly, yeah. He's got everything to gain, you know, with Alberto in the qualifying rounds, you know, 1-2-4, and then just going on to into the semi-final with just missing one target. So, you know, it's and we just had a no target there, so it'll be reset and for him to go again. Here he goes now.
Oh.
Yeah, there you go.
With a hit, there we go. Now with two targets done. Both had good kills to start with, so that should take some pressure off.
And the last time that Clemens has won a gold medal was back in 2008 during the World Cup, and it was 2011 for Fernandez. So I'm sure that Clemens is winning that again. Of course, he did win a bronze last year in Lonato.
Yeah, exactly. Oh. And you know, maybe he wants a different colour now. But I don't think he... Well, at the moment, the way he stands, that it's not gold at the moment because he's just come off from the miss there.
But it's pretty early on.
It's very early on. With 12 targets to go. Quick bit of calculation there.
Nice job. Good mathematics. I'm proud of you. Okay, so the amount of time that Clemens takes to shoot seems almost like a week compared to Fernandez.
Yeah.
He's come off of that miss with a hit. On now to Fernandez. Nice with a hit. It is interesting to watch the different styles of the shooters and, you know, how long it takes someone to shoot or how fast they shoot.
Exactly,
or
yeah.
Their pre-shot routine.
Oh. Yeah. And it seems like it's now working for Clemens again.
Now, if I remember correctly, your pre-shot routine, you always are wiping yourself on the shoulder, aren't you?
I was waiting for that. I knew something was coming.
You definitely have a signature routine there.
No, what it is because I wear a necklace, and sometimes it gets caught up, and it really, really hurts when it's in the wrong place. So,
you're not just wiping your hand then.
No.
Just moving your
exactly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Just so that it really hurts. I tell you.
I'm sure. So why don't you take it off?
I can't.
No.
I don't know how to. It's my head's grown since I put it on. So, you know, I just can't get it around it.
Oh, Aaron. We have got Clemens down by one. Fernandez is shooting a perfect 6 out of 6. 9 more to go to find out who's going to be on the highest step of the podium.
Yeah, at the moment it looks like Alberto's certainly got things underway.
He certainly does.
With some great support there. Although it looks like he's not too worried about it.
With that breath, maybe.
Whoa.
Oh, oh. Stefan there with a miss, unfortunately.
You could just see that it was just a little bit slow there.
Oh, and Alberto, not gaining on that there.
I wonder what's going on there. If it's the wind, if it's the sun, if it's...
We can't say there's a cloud in the way because there isn't
there's
none.
There's none. We're praying for a cloud.
In fact, looking at that grass, I think it is praying for it too.
All right, Clemens gets back into it. Let's see if Fernandez can do the same.
Oh.
Yeah, he's back on the road. Now at the halfway stage with Stefan Clemens there with two misses to Alberto's one. It's certainly going to be interesting these last few targets now.
Oh.
Nice.
Then he's back underway there with a nice hit. Let's see if Alberto can follow suit. Really see there. The graphics is gone.
Mm-hmm.
I think it may have been a no target because Alberto has not moved there and didn't fire a shot. So, looking at that, here he goes again.
Oh, there you go.
Back in the swing of things.
Nice.
With a hit. There we go. Now with six targets remaining, still anything can happen. A little bit like Thunderbirds there.
Well, I'm sure that both of these guys would love to get onto the podium with the gold around their neck, but it is certainly nice that they're both going home with medals.
Exactly, yeah, that's a great thing. That's a great feeling to have, knowing that with such the effort you had to put in this weekend, and then to finally make it to the last two, so you know that you're going home with something, at least, to show for the great work you've put in this weekend.
Oh.
Nice.
Both going on there with a hit. Stefan there, just getting himself ready.
Oh.
Nice hit from Clemens, and back on now to Fernandez.
Oh.
We'll have to, there we go.
Quick.
Yeah.
Quicker to the point.
Yeah, I was just going to say, if the cameraman can catch up. Four targets remaining now.
Who's your money on? Give it to me.
I think there's going to be a shoot-off.
Really?
I think there's going to be a shoot-off.
Okay.
Thanks for telling me. Are we going to be here a while?
And I'll have to buy your dinner then, right?
Exactly, because those sandwiches are gone stale now, I tell you.
Oh.
Nice. Fernandez following through beautifully. Three more to go. Fernandez up by one over Clemens.
Here we go, three targets remaining. Fernandez is positioned at the moment to take gold medal, but Stefan Clemens has three targets to try and change that. We will now have the final three targets of this gold medal final. Here's the two coaches there.
It's nice they can just sit there and talk instead of ignoring each other and thinking,
exactly.
I want my my boy to win.
Yeah, it just goes to show again, even from a coach's perspective, there's no hardships felt there at all. And Alberto there looks like with a miss.
With a miss. You could have been onto something.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's just see if this is contagious to Clemens or not. If not, we will go into a sudden death shoot-off. Depending on how the next two targets go.
Yep. Here we
Today must have been a day of shoot-offs after qualification. Shoot-off.
Yep. Exactly,
yeah. Two shoot-offs to find out who was going into the bronze medal match.
Yep. Let's see if Clemens there can cash in on that.
Oh.
Here he goes. With a hit.
Nice.
There. And now Alberto. Here we go.
Oh.
Oh, with a miss.
Another miss.
Now that's surprising.
That is a huge surprise.
Yep.
And it is Clemens who can now nail it and go home.
All he needs is this target for the gold medal.
Can he do it? What do you think?
Mm-hmm. Let's just see what the...
I think he's got it in him. I think he can do it. I think that...
Here we go.
All right.
Here we go. And yeah, here we go.
Yes, yeah. He's won the gold. Wow, what a tight, tight final this has been. Let's just wait to see the last shot here from Fernandez.
Yeah.
And here he is, our gold medalist.
There we go. Well done.
Very, very well done. Gold medalist, Stefan Clemens from France. Fantastic shooting. Really just held on to it to the very, very end. You can tell he's completely psyched about this, and rightfully should be. Well, let's see if we can find an image or two of our silver medalist.
There we go. Nice still. That's fantastic shooting from Fernandez there.
Really, really nice. Exactly. And there he is, our silver medalist.
There
Fernandez,
he is.
Alberto Fernandez from Spain. Really, really great shooting. Unfortunate two last misses on the last three targets has put him down one step on the podium. And you were pretty much calling him right, Aaron.
Yeah, exactly. I know. Exactly what I said. That was exactly my prediction. I told you so.
Well, listen, I just want to thank you so very much for being with me today. I know that I had to twist your arm for you
to do it.
It's always so nice to have you by my side. I'd much rather do a gold medal interview with you. And that's my next plan, okay?
Thank you so much, Hillary.
Good luck, Aaron.
Thanks a lot. Take care.
Will you please welcome your medalists? Medals will be presented by Mr. Dimitris Loros, ISSF Technical Delegate, Chairman of the ISSF Shotgun Committee. He is accompanied by Mr. Jesus Martinez, Secretary General of the Real Spain Shooting Federation. Your bronze medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Alexei Alipov. Your silver medalist, representing Spain, Alberto Fernandez. And your gold medalist representing France, Stefan Clemens. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of France.